everyone, welcome back to my channel. For those of you that are new to my channel, welcome to my channel. My name is Hannah and I am a first year kindergarten teacher right now in Maryland, but somewhat recently I made the decision that I'm going to be moving down to North Carolina this summer, which means I have to get a new job. I'm moving to a new state, can no longer work at the job that I have now, unfortunately, so I have been going through the interviewing process to get a new job. So today I want to share with you guys all of the things that I've learned from this interviewing experience. I want to tell you guys about how I prepared for the interviews, how the interviews went and the structure of them. I want to talk about the different things we talked about in our interviews. I went to Instagram and asked you guys what kinds of things you wanted to know about the interview process. So I have a lot of questions from you guys, which is so awesome. And I can't wait to share my experience and all of my tips that I have from the interviewing process. These tips helped me secure the job that I recently just got. So I would love to share them with you so that you guys can hopefully be successful interviewing as well. With before you even get into an interview, there is so much you need to do to prepare. I think preparation is one of the best things you can do. It'll save you a lot of stress, a lot of nerves, and a lot of anxiety if you are prepared before you go into that interview, because there is nothing worse than going into an interview, being asked questions, and knowing nothing about the school. So the best thing you can do, number one, is research the school or the district beforehand. So if you're interviewing for a specific school, go look the school up. You can get so much information from a school or a district's website, and if you pull things from that, they will really think that you did your research and that you know a lot about the school and that you are really interested and invested in their school. And that impresses the interviewers. They like to know that you did your research and that you are really interested in their school. So do your research beforehand. I would say that some of the big things to look for on their website, if you only have a little bit of time, is number one, look at their vision statement or mission statement, whichever they have on there, or maybe they have both. Those statements are normally very short, clear, and to the point, and they tell you just basically what the school is about. So a lot of the schools that I interviewed with, their statement said something along the lines of empowering the whole child, you know, bettering the children to make them beneficial for our society, something like that. So basically talking about educating the entire child and not just talking about reading, math, and writing, and you know, the little subjects and stuff. So look at those mission statements, and you want to find something that you can relate to, because they like to hear that you are a good fit for their school. So if you can relate to their mission statement in some way, that is an awesome perk and they will love to hear that. Another thing to look for is the curriculum. Now, not every school district or school has this on their website, and it's sometimes can also be kind of hard to find, but if you are able to find their curriculum, that makes it even better, because number one, if you know the curriculum, you can talk about that with them, and that's one other advantage that you have, that you are already familiar with it. Or number two, if you don't know the curriculum, you can do a little bit of research on that as well and see if the curriculum kind of aligns with the way that you teach and your teaching style and everything. So if you can find things about their curriculum, awesome. If not, it's not a big deal. They will probably tell you about it in the interview, but it does just make you that much more prepared if you do know a little something about it beforehand. Something else I always like to look at too is just the staff directory. I think it's super interesting to see the different people that work there, and it's not for the case of being able to just judge a book by its cover and, you know, look at the staff and see if they look like people you'd want to work with, but it's more so look how big the grade levels are, look how many teachers there are, look at the support staff that's there, see what kind of support staff they have, if they have specialists or coaches or whatever they have. See the different age ranges. Are they a younger school, or do they have a really wide range of people with different experiences? Just kind of look at all of that, because honestly, you're going to be working with those people for a very long time, hopefully. And so it's good to just kind of know who you're going to be working with, what the teams look like, the different support that you have, and all of that stuff. So just looking at their staff directory and looking at all the different positions is a really good tool, and I think it just helps picture yourself in that school a little bit better. So one other thing that I do to prepare is I make like a little cheat sheet kind of for each school that I'm applying for or interviewing with. I don't want to show you the school name, so I'm just going to put that over, but at the top I put the school name so it has that, so I remember which school it's for, and I also put the position that I'm interviewing for, so what grade level it is. And then underneath of that I also have this covered up, but I have the principal and the assistant principal's names, just because they're most likely going to be in your interview and it'd be really embarrassing if you don't remember their names. So I have those written down just in case. And something to note is if you can find it on their website, which most of the time it is listed, look at if the principal is a doctor or if they're just a Mr. or a Mrs. or a Miss. I always feel really bad when I find out that people are considered doctors and I didn't know, and I'm calling them something else, because some people take that very seriously. They worked hard for that degree. So check and note and see if they are a doctor or if they are not, so that you can be calling them by the right name. The next thing on my list are my highlights. So the highlights that I write down are basically what I just talked about, all that research that I did. I pick out things from the school that are unique to that school or stand out to me, or things that I can relate to, because then I can bring those points up in my interview and talk about them, and then they see that I did my research and they are a lot more impressed with that. So I put down a whole bunch of highlights that I want to talk about. And then at the bottom, I put a section for questions that I want to ask them. So if I come across some things on their website that I'm curious about, or if I just have questions come to mind, I put those questions at the bottom so that at the end of the interview, I am remembered to ask them. Because the interviewers will always ask at the end if you have any questions. And it's good to have questions. Always ask questions. It makes them once again feel like you are invested and you are curious about their school. So you should always ask questions. And I'm going to talk a little bit later about some of the questions that you should ask or can ask. But I just write those down at the bottom so that I have them in my mind and I remember them when it's time. Okay. And then of course, a couple other things you can do to prepare is make sure you have your resume updated, your cover letter. This time around, my interview process was a little bit different because I actually did everything on Zoom since we are right now in quarantine, so I can't go to the school and interview. So it was a little bit different. I wasn't handing papers to the admin as they were interviewing me, but if you are going to an interview in person, you want to make sure you have copies of your resume, your cover letter, maybe your teaching philosophy, maybe letters of recommendation in there. And if you've already been teaching, maybe a couple observation notes printed out that so that your admin did or whoever observes you in school, maybe have a couple of your successful observations in there as well to give out to people. Okay, so this video is gonna get pretty long, I already know it. I had a lot of questions from you guys asking what kind of questions they asked in interviews. So I wanted to share with you guys the questions and the answers that I gave and just some tips on how to give answers and how to come up with them, because this is the most stressful part I feel like about interviewing, because how are you supposed to prepare when you have no idea what questions they're going to ask? It's so hard. But I will say one thing that I did beforehand is I went online and I looked up like 2020's most asked interviewing questions for teachers and went off of there. So the first thing I did was I made a little cheat sheet using those questions and answer suggestions in order to kind of have some things on hand, because it's so easy and so common when you go into an interview to kind of like and just kind of get lost, and now you're just like, oh my gosh, I have no idea what to say to this. So having a little cheat sheet with common questions and things that you can talk about make it a lot easier to kind of spark your mind and, you know, get some juice flowing up in there so that you do have something to go off of. So I'm gonna tell you about these questions that I found, and then I also have a couple other questions that I encountered in multiple interviews, so I will tell you about them too. Okay, so the first question that was a common question for 2020 is, how do you think you can become a good teacher? Basically, what I think the best answer for this is to talk about how you can grow as a teacher and as an educator and as a person, talking about professional development, talking about how you are always trying to better yourself, talking about that growth. I like to bring up how I'm a role model for my students, so if I expect them to keep learning and trying and doing their best and bettering themselves, then I need to do the same thing. So those were the big points that I brought up in that question, just talking about bettering yourself and continuing to educate yourself. Another question was, why work here? They like to know why you chose their school and their district. So the big thing here is to pull out those similarities and things you have in common with them and talk about how you match on belief systems, you match on your values, maybe you really like the area or the diversity or whatever it may be. Just talk about what you like about their school, because they love to know what makes you unique and driven to their school and how you're a good match for them. Another one is talking about your teaching experience. So I feel like that's a pretty self-explanatory one. Just talk about your background. Talk about all the places you've interned, the places you've worked, different grade levels. And one thing to note is, always talk about how they were positive experiences. Talk about how they helped you grow as a person and as an educator. Even if there were negative things about them, now's not the time to bring that up. You want to bring out the good things and be optimistic about those opportunities that you had, because no matter what, you can always find positive things to talk about from it. If you didn't agree with the way that your mentor teacher was teaching when you were student teaching, okay, but talk about how it made you realize what you do believe in as a teacher and what kind of teacher you want to be. You took that, flipped it around, and learned from it. So those are the big thing, is to just talk about the positivity and all those experiences that you've had. Another big question is, what can I expect from my students? My big answer to this question was that my kids can expect of me what I expect of them. So what I expect of them is honest, that they're willing to try, and that they're respectful of each other. And so I expect that of them, but they can also expect that of me, because I am a role model for them. I would never ask them to do something that I wouldn't do. That's just not fair. Definitely think of what your values are and what you do expect of your kids, but also talk about how you're gonna do the same thing because you are the role model for them. Okay, the next question that I thought was interesting, I did not get this question but in any of my interviews, but the question was, how would you approach your students on the first day? So if I had gotten this question, I probably would just talk about, you know, positivity, welcoming, and not even just focusing on the kids. If the parents come come with them on the first day, talking about how parents are just as important to your classroom as their kids are. So they need to feel welcome and they need to be treated with respect as well. Another question that was a common one for 2020 is, what are your teaching methods? So really, you just kind of have to talk about your methods and what you have experience with. Now, I will say, this is probably the biggest thing that I got in all of my interviews. They asked me this question in every interview, what are my teaching methods like? And most schools nowadays are moving towards, if not already fully submerged in, inquiry-based learning. So if you don't really know what that is, it's more explorative. It's more the kids guiding their own learning. So what it looks like is you have an objective or a target and you kind of set that goal for the day with the kids. They know what their goal is. They know what they're going to be achieving at the end, but then you kind of let them choose their strategies on how they get there. So maybe you lay out manipulatives that you would like them to use, but they can kind of use them how they please to get to their goal. So schools right now are super into the inquiry-based learning. So if you can talk about that and you can talk about how you really like to run your classroom that way, then that is absolutely awesome. Like, I can't even tell you how excited the interviewers were when they heard that that's what I have experience with and that's what I like to do, because they were talking about how people still are kind of like teaching more in the traditional way, which is fine for some people, but a lot of schools are moving more towards this new style of learning. So if you can, and if that is something that you're comfortable talking about, that's definitely something to look into and to talk about in your interview. Okay, and then the last questions that are very common, which are probably the most uncomfortable questions to answer, are, tell us about your strengths and tell us about your weaknesses. Honestly, your strengths can be anything that shows that you're professional, anything that shows that you are adaptable, flexible, collaborative, you know, working on a team, like you're good at that kind of stuff. Weaknesses is the hard part, because you don't want to make yourself sound dumb, but you also don't want to sit there and say, I don't have any weaknesses, because everybody has weaknesses. So what I like to say for this one is saying no to tasks or favors and stuff. I'm a person that if you ask me to do something, I really don't like to say no. I like to try to please people and help people in any way that I can. So saying no is hard for me. So if I already have a lot on my plate and someone offers something else to me, I will most likely say yes. I think that that's a pretty safe weakness to talk about, because honestly, it's kind of a positive in a way. Like, I'm always willing to help and I always am trying to help, but sometimes it puts a little bit too much on my plate. So it's a weakness, but can kind of also be turned into a strength. So that's, I think that one works out pretty well. And then another one a lot of people I've heard say is that asking for help might be a weakness of theirs. They're a little bit more independent and maybe they just aren't used to asking for help. So when I do use this one, I like to put it out on the table like that, but then I always like to say, you know, but I work on it, I try really hard, and I've gotten a lot better with it. You know, making it sound like it's something that you are trying to improve on that, but any weakness that you give, you can always say, you know, how you're working towards a goal to better yourself in that area. So moving on to some of the questions that I got from my interviews over and over. The first one is, what do you expect out of your administration? And this is always interesting, because usually the administration are the people that are interviewing you, so you're kind of telling them like what you want from them. But I always just kind of talk about support, like a cheerleader, but also someone that is going to give me constructive criticism and feedback that I can grow from, someone that's there to help me grow. So I mean, truly be honest with them and talk about what you expect from them. But I think big things are that they want to hear that you guys are going to be able to work as a team, and that your end goal is to keep growing, so your admin is there to help you do that. Another one is talking about your class management. Now, this is totally up to you on what your class management style is. This could be something maybe you want to write down, because there can be a lot of parts to class management, like discipline, what your classroom is set up like, how you handle different behaviors and different things. So this might be something you want to have jotted down so you don't miss any parts. But I will tell you that most principals are not looking to hear that you have a clip chart on your wall and, you know, you move people's names up and down. It's effective for some maybe, but I know that a lot of people, they are kind of moving away from that. They kind of want to hear more about how those undesired behaviors or situations that are going on are turned into a learning experience, and how we sit and we talk about why it was not okay, how we can grow from it. So we're still talking about that growing aspect, because we're trying to better the whole child, and even those emotional and social aspects need to be developed. So when talking about classroom management, I would definitely take that into consideration. Okay, and then the last question I got a lot was about parent communication, which is super important, because parents are just as important in the classroom as their children are. So asking how I would communicate with parents, I think the big thing to talk about is whatever works for them. I mean, if maybe you have some parents that have emails, some don't. Some like to get phone calls, some don't. Some like to get papers home, some don't. Just really whatever works best for the parents, because they have every right to know what's going on with their kid in their classroom. So you need to be able to communicate with them in any way, shape, or form that they need from you. Okay, so those are all the big questions that I was asked. Just a few more tips on how to answer questions. Another thing that I noticed a lot was that, sorry, I keep looking at this notebook with my notes and stuff written down here. But another thing that I noticed a lot from the administration was that they were really digging into me and asking a lot more like pressuring questions and, you know, like why would you do that, which is super intimidating, let me tell you. But also I know that they were doing it, and they told me they were doing it because they were trying to figure out how my brain works and how I problem solve. So you may get a lot of funky questions. I remember one of my interviews, they asked me if I was coming to a potluck, like a school-wide potluck, what would I bring? What dish would I bring? And like, that's such a random question, but it's fun and it's different. It's a little bit less stressful, but they were just kind of trying to figure out like, where is my mind? I said mac and cheese, like crock pot mac and cheese, and they asked me why. And I told them like, because it's a very commonly liked food. Like, most people like mac and cheese. It's also a comfort food. It's also, there's so many different variations of it, and you can do so much with mac and cheese. And so they took that answer, and like from that, they probably got to know a little bit more about me, that I like to please a lot of people, or, you know, make a lot of people happy at once. I like comforting things. I like things to like give me that warm, fuzzy feeling. Like, you learn things about people that way. So there's just a lot of different things that they'll ask you sometimes that like, you don't really understand why they're doing that at the time, but a lot of it is to get in your brain and pick apart things and just kind of get to know the inside of you as well. So like problem solving skills and how you would handle tough situations, or just kind of figuring out how your brain works. And then another big thing is give as many scenarios as you can. If you have experiences that you can bring up, like specific experiences, a lot of times they might ask you about a time where you were in a rough situation and how did you handle it. Think about a time, like a physical time that you remember that you were in a really tough situation and how you turned it around and handled it. They love to hear real life experiences because it makes them see how you handled the situation and kind of gives them a better visual of how it would play out, so that they can then figure out like, well, would that work well in our school, or would that way of handling it really not work with what we're all about? So giving those real life situations is awesome. Okay, so there were a couple other questions that you guys asked on Instagram about the interviews. So another one that was asked was, how many questions did they ask? This really varied from interview to interview. I would say probably, there was probably around 10 for each. I would say they lasted a pretty good amount of time. One interview, I had the interview, and then there was a second like follow-up screening interview. This one had a lot of questions, and these were also questions that they like really, really pressure you and keep asking like why, just to get into your head. But most of them had about 10. One of them had a lot more than that, just because we were talking a lot and like other things kind of came up. It was more of a conversation for us than it was an interview. So really depends on the school. It really depends on the answers you're giving too. If you're not giving them enough, they might ask more questions to once again figure out what's going on in your head. But if you're giving them a lot of really good information, they might skip questions because maybe you already touched on it in another question, or they might not feel it's necessary to ask that anymore. So really depends on how the interview is going, but I would say probably expect somewhere around 10. Okay, another question I have is, did you apply to specific positions, or did you just sign up for a virtual job fair? I applied for specific positions. I was actually fully intended to go to a virtual job fair. I was just waiting to hear the information about it. But that didn't end up happening. So I just applied for specific positions, and some of them, it turned out to be like, you just kind of enter a pool for the district and then they will pull from that. So I did do that for a couple of them, but most of them, it was like, I knew the school and the grade level, and that was what I was applying for. Okay. Another question was, how do you impress a principal if you are a first year teacher? This was something that I was kind of nervous about because I mean, I'm still fairly new to the game here. I'm still very young, if you think about it. So impressing a principal, it was nerve-wracking. After your first year teaching, you just have to be confident in yourself and trust that you know what you're talking about. You have the experiences to talk from now, and you just have grown so much in this past year. So just be confident and you'll be okay. And I actually think that interviewers like young teachers a lot because things are always changing, and it's good to have fresh minds come in with new ideas that are just creative. And I'm not saying that older teachers aren't creative with ideas and stuff, but it is nice sometimes to have you know, just straight out of college, fresh young minds coming in and bringing in just new ideas. So I think that at some points you have an advantage. I mean, there's pros and cons to both, but just be confident and you'll be okay. The last questions, I got a couple questions asking about what questions you should ask as the person being interviewed at the end of the interview. So like I said, you should always, 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 always ask questions. It makes you look like you are interested, which you should be. So one of the questions I always ask, I think this is something very important to me, and that's really the biggest tip I can give you, is ask what is important to you. I mean, if you are curious about something, ask the question. The big thing that I like to always hear about is how do they use technology? I just think it's very interesting, and some schools have a lot of technology, some schools don't. I personally like to use technology, so when looking at different schools, I like to hear about how I can use it at their school if it's an option. So asking them, do they have iPads? Do they have computers? Do the kids have access to computers? What do the teachers have access to? Just all that kind of stuff, I think, is a great question, at least for me, to ask, because it's something I'm interested in. But it's also a really safe question to ask too, because there is just some schools where you just don't know what questions to ask, and that's a question you can literally ask anybody, because I mean, either they have it or they don't have it, so you'll find out. Another question that I like to ask about is collaborative planning. So if you are working on a team with other teachers, do they plan together? What kind of resources do they share together? Maybe they don't really plan together. If you ask about how you work with your team and what that looks like, then they'll give you a good idea. Maybe you don't like really working closely with other people, so you might find out that this is a good spot for you because the team doesn't plan together, or maybe you're someone that needs co-planning, so great, your team plans together. So asking about that, I think, is also a great idea. If you weren't able to find their curriculum on their website, I always ask about their curriculum, because you want to know what you're going to be using, and then you can do some research on it if you need to. So that's another one. And then another safe question is to ask about professional development. What kinds of things do they offer to help you continue to grow? That's a good question, because it makes you look like you want to keep growing as a teacher, but then also gives you some good answers on how you can keep growing. I know this is on a lot of people's minds, but one thing I would not recommend asking in an interview is about the salary. Number one, your administration, like your principal and vice principal, really don't have much say in your salary, so they can't really do much about it. And teacher pay scales are pretty set. You can pretty much go on any district website and find out what the teacher pay scale is. You can either type it in Google, or they'll have a link at the top somewhere that you can get to it. Normally it's on like the human resources page, or on whatever page you go on to apply to that district. So you can find that online. I would not recommend asking that in your interview. It's just not really the most appropriate thing to do, I feel. It's just also not really necessary to ask it, so try to avoid asking questions about your money and benefits and stuff yet. I think right now, when you're in an interview still, you know, you haven't gotten the job offer yet, now's a good time to just focus strictly on the school atmosphere, and then later on down the line, if they do offer you the job, maybe then you can start asking about benefits and maybe the pay scale and stuff like that. All right, I know this was a super long video, I am so sorry, but I really hoped you guys found some of these tips to be helpful, and some of the questions that I asked, or that I was asked, to be helpful. I think that this process can be so stressful, but it also doesn't need to be that stressful. You can help diminish your stress and your anxiety so much by just preparing yourself and doing a little bit of research first, and you'll feel so much better about it. These tips helped me get the job that I recently just got, and I am so excited about it, so I really hope that it helps you guys too. If you have any other questions, you can always head over to my Instagram, which is They Call Me Miss S, and I'd be happy to answer some more for you guys. So thank you so much for watching this video, and I will talk to you next time. Bye. Show the limits with you.